The following scenes were originally intended for the classic Al Pacino film, Serpico. Due to some of the graphic drug-related nature of some of these scenes, they were cut from the film by director Sidney Lumet.
Freeze!
One of the people who worked on the film always felt these scenes should not have been removed.
Now that last scene was a really real life-like fight scene, and it had the robbery and also police chase. You could not take it out of the picture, but they didn't listen. The bastards.
Ready, go.
This scene here showcases Serpico's love for alcohol and outlandish jazz music.
Okay, go. Drink.
I could never get my message to Mr. Lumet heard. I said, Sidney, my main man. Do you need more smack? I did it all for him. But these scenes, they were really good. This is the drug deal gone wrong. It has it all, my main man. This next scene has Serpico's cult member friend, who was taken out of the movie completely due to a crack cocaine addiction. But first, we are going to see Serpico, who shows his ability to spin around in front of people shooting heroin.
Come back. Oh, this is fucking crazy, dude. All right, good. Okay, I'll do something here. Ready?
Go. Very, very theatrical. You're killing the jihad. You're possessed. You want to kill?
All new, from Pepper North, Stargazer Hot Sauce. Stargazer Hot Sauce is the most legendary hot sauce in all the land.
It's normal.
Come on, guy, hurry up!
Made from fresh Carolina Reaper peppers, habanero peppers, COVID-19, vinegar, carrots, jalapenos, and also a small part of Gary Coleman. Stargazer Hot Sauce has a Scoville unit rating of 17 million. And should not be eaten by children under the age of 6.
What the fuck is going on?
Stargazer Hot Sauce? When you can't afford to crash a plane into a World Trade Center and burn to death, just eat Stargazer.
I don't know.
I think you're having a panic attack.
Oh, okay, so we're gonna do some hot sauce a bit here. This is Stargazer. It's not quite the bomb, if you ever had the bomb, but it's pretty good. It's 118,000 Scoville units. It's a pretty tough guy. What's up, sir? You want some hot sauce? This guy's from the Donnie Brasco movies. He's Donnie Brasco's buddy, Johnny Lasco. Johnny Lasco? You think you can handle hot sauce? Yeah, let's put this down here. Yeah, this is going to be here. Let's have some of this stuff. That might be more than you need. There you go, hold this. Wait for it. Do not need that just yet. Wait for it. Oh shit. Yeah, okay, that's good.
This is the thing.
Okay, ready? Put it and go. One, two, three. Whoa. Whoa. How's that feel? You're hanging in there. I think that stuff's really hot. You have to burn it. Oh my god, it's just picking up, man. You alright? Wow, that's just fine. Holy shit. Oh, wow. I don't even want to talk. You want a drink?
Hello. The following is a message from the Ambulance Association of America. If you have friends who are dying near you, whether it's from gunshot wounds, rape, or marijuana, and you can't use a telephone to call for help, you must understand these basic rules so you can save a life. 1. Help your friend stand up, and then carry him, kind of like a big retarded baby. 2. Get another friend, whose name is most likely Bertram, and cross your arms together and lock them in a judo hold. You can now see your dying friend on your arms, just like a Persian ruler, and carry him to a nearby Arby's restaurant to regain his strength with their fabulous deals. 3. If your friend is not moving, get another friend, whose name is most likely Jarvis. Pick your friend up together and rest him across your knees. Next, slowly spin him inwards and stand up. At this point, go out to the street and begin yelling for someone to give you a ride. If this doesn't work, just walk to a nearby go-kart track. 4. If you notice your friend is dead, just hold his arm and remember moments you spent together at Tommy's bowling alley. If you like, have Bertram and Jarvis put their hands underneath your dead friend's body, and they too can remember moments spent together at Tommy's bowling alley.
My glass. Oh, that's hot as hell.
Where are my glasses?
Over there.
Where's your glasses?
Oh, go, go. It's over there.
Where?
Find it.
I don't know.
Where?
I don't know.
Where the hell's your glass?
I'm looking for it, man.
Oh, find it.
Let's get another glass.
Oh, fuck.
Drinking? Cider? Whatever,
let's go. It's better than that. Let's go. Run it outside. Go outside. Oh, yeah, yeah. Go outside, yeah.
Fuck.
What are
we drinking?
Not that. Something.
Go.
Cider. It hurts so bad. We're tougher than ever. Oh my god, that's hot. This rock music is amazing. Yeah. Go the whole movie. Ugh! Here, finish it, grab more. There we go. Okay. Yeah! That was fucking awesome! Now we're alcoholics. Wait, come in the frame, right here, right here, right here.
No
right
more.
Go right here, just like this. Come in the frame. In the frame, come on.
Oh, fuck.
Come on, come on.
Hold on.
I'm gonna clean the floor. Okay, ready? We're alcoholics. We're alcoholics. Here. That's awesome.
Holy fuck, dude, no more.
Ready, put that on.
It's on, hold on.
Yeah, we got over.
You're dying, I'm helping you.
Something's
happening. Oh, I need to go to the
hospital.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Perfect. Yeah, you gotta get that back. Here.
So 70s, man.
Ready? Go. I'm gonna come in the frame kind of this way. All right, close to the camera, walking away.
There you go.
I need the perfect like kind of stroll.
There you go. And turn back a couple times.
I need the song though. I need like a nice little fucking like nice guitar thing to jam to, right?
We're both dying or
something. You guys gotta look up, right? Okay, we're both sick and dying.
Ready?